nightmare. Welcome back, Monster fans, to this edition of Monster City. I'm your host and hot creator, Scott Michael. In this episode, we'll be packing up our semi-trailers and moving them to a new location for the 2004 Halloween season. This year, we're located at Event Center Las Vegas. We've also transformed our one haunted house into two. We've split it right down the middle, creating the Hotel Hysteria and the Hysteria City Prison. The Las Vegas Event Center seemed a prime location to hold our 2004 Halloween event. We packed up our semi-trailers and headed south on the I-15 freeway. Once our trailers arrived at the event center, we prepared to put on one of Las Vegas' biggest Halloween events, Nightmare at Event Center Las Vegas. This year, operating would prove to be a bit difficult. This year, it seemed as if we were being stalked by the Ripper and his friends. We would soon find out we had a couple of real monsters lurking deep within the bowels of Hysteria City. Undaunted by the thoughts of evil deeds being done behind our back, we continued on our quest to create Las Vegas' biggest haunted event. The Nightmare Halloween event would encompass the entire event center location. The trail would make its way through the Speed Demons Raceway, the Industrial Nightmare Pavilion, the Wasteland Paintball Adventure, Nightmare Alley, the Fantasy Garden Trail, and the Pumpkin Patch. The trail ended up here in the rear parking lot. Behind the scenes, the Hysteria City crew works hard to make this madness happen. This year, Helvis is working hard once again with the crew to produce another quality event. He's a year-round Las Vegas Elvis impersonator who loves to work at Hysteria City during the Halloween season. Elvis is in charge of setup procedures as well as operations. You may also see him performing as Dead Elvis or the Hysteria City Butcher.
I'm originally from Santa Ana, California.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
I like the fact that I get to come out here and build something and scare people with it. Just to make people happy, get them all out to have a little bit of fun, bring the whole family and kids out, make a day of it. Monster City! Monster City! Monster City! Monster City! Hysteria Limited, bro!
And more work.
Our next haunted house veteran is Abner Psycho Latino Loco Aldana. He's from Mexico City, and some say he came straight from a psycho ward.
Well, I hope you enjoyed this, because I'm not.
Abner is in charge of special effects makeup, prop construction, as well as setup and operations.
City. I don't know, it's very, very scary. I like it. It's kind of warm. Scared people. I like scared people. I mean, there's some props, some monsters. Helping everything here to make all this stuff, all this room. But it's a nightmare. I wish everything.
Lighting the pathway to success is none other than Rick the Viking Schechter from Salem, Oregon.
Lots of work. Yeah, well, it's great to be here, and, you know, I hope you guys are just really enjoying this day, because it is close to fun. So, see you here.
Rick is a professional technician who will provide all the special effects lighting needed for this venue. Meanwhile, Don the Ripper and his friends have been working hard on a plot to destroy our haunted attraction. Will they succeed? With thoughts of evildoers in the back of our minds, we continue on our quest to build our haunted attraction. Scott and the boys are busy installing Nightmare Alley. They worked hard for 2 weeks building and painting the panels for this maze. We've all been waiting for this moment. The time has finally come to set up one of our newest modular haunts, Nightmare Alley. This open-air maze was designed to go alongside the existing batting cages. The batting cages would have to be left open during regular operating hours. so we designed the maze with movable interior scare boxes. And Elvis designed his new hairdo. The alleyway open-air maze was coming together nicely. My anticipation to see the props and details go into place was extremely high. As they say, all good things are worth waiting for. From out of the darkness, the wrath of Don the Ripper strikes. Rick would be the first to learn the details of the Ripper's evil deeds against our haunt. The Ripper's demons were about to be unleashed upon Rick's mutated body.
I want my stone! It's time for some things. It is served in the main galley. Look, I'm skin and bones. Well, just bones, practically.
The Ripper had turned Rick into some sort of mutated cyborg pirate. And now only time would tell if the Ripper would succeed in his evil plot. Not knowing of Rick's dire situation, we continued with our setup. We completely unloaded all of the trailers and set up all of the ramps. We organized all of our materials and prepared ourselves to set up the 2004 Nightmare at Event Center Halloween production. Soon, all of our facades and walls were going up into place. We had to fabricate several of the facade wall panels for the prison on location. Remember, kids, do not try this at home. Once all of the wall panels were built, we began to paint. It only took us about 4 hours to complete all of the paintwork inside and out for both haunts. Of course, there was still a lot of detail to do. We started by adding an industrial facade to the prison. We then added an authentic 1930s circus animal cage. This is what's called the base of the face. And this is what's called the back, Jack. Any way you look at it, this prison is shaping up to be a pretty decent haunted house. With all of the outside wall panels done on the prison, our attention turns to the hotel. This haunt's exterior is complete with the exception of some final details. It's almost time to turn our attention to the interior courtyard. Meanwhile, Rick is being tortured because of his knowledge of Don the Ripper's evil plans to destroy our haunt. But little does the Ripper know that the good wizards and trolls of Hysteria City will always protect. Can Hysteria City survive? And will Rick get out of his dire situation? Or will the Ripper fulfill his evil plan?